Well, it is so good to be in the room. It's great to have everyone who's joining us at home as well. You're in the room with us, absolutely, and trust you're having an amazing day as well. And gosh, worship was going off. I felt like we could have just kept on going. Come on, we got a way maker. Aren't you thankful for a way maker? Even when you don't see it, he's moving. Even when you don't feel it, he's moving. And I just thank God that you can't lock God out of moving. How amazing, hey, to think that when the Sunday before we all had some time in close proximity at our own homes, we got to share the miracle of us being able to say, hey, we've purchased a permanent home here in Melbourne. That was the last Sunday we had in person, and now the next live person moment that we have, we are all getting to collectively respond out of our hearts to see this miracle come about. Are you pretty excited about that? Yes. Trust that you are. And team, thank you so much. You're amazing. And I think we're going to sing Miracle Waymaker a little bit more later on. Let's do that, because I just think you can't stop with the. That's just like, if there's a truth we need to know he's a waymaker. And I just pray that through this whole journey for all of us, when we're seeing and realizing what we're all a part of, I pray, Lord, that it's enlarging all of our faith. Like all of us are going, wow, God, like, you know, and just having that increased expectation of what God doesn't just want to do collectively, but he wants to do individually. And I love that. And as Nadia said it, it's Expansion Sunday. It's our first ever Expansion Sunday, which we're going to do every year, declaring what God's got in front of us. But at the same time, we're declaring it's Celebration Sunday. Come on, it's Breakthrough Sunday. It's Miracle Sunday. And it's a time of great joy. It's a time of great freedom. And it's a time that, again, collectively, we are going to establish and just see God do a miracle, an absolute miracle. And so if you're fresh to church today, or you're fresh joining us at home or online, wherever you are, you've come at a really exciting time for us. And I know you probably already picked that up. You've already caught that in the air in that sense. But it's been and again, it's a massive honor. We always say this, but it is a massive honor of ours to have you with us and to have you joining us. And I just want to say that today is really a landmark moment for us at Life. Like, it's a landmark moment. Like, it's one of those moments in time that you will look back on and go, remember that moment that God entrusted this incredible miracle and we were a part of it. But we have the great joy of taking a step of faith as we have, and now together sowing into the future of our new home, of our permanent home here in Melbourne. And I believe it's not just sowing in to the future of our church, but I believe we're sowing into the future of our city. I believe we're sowing into the future of God's kingdom and the church of Jesus Christ here in Melbourne and everywhere that he wants to lead it. And so I really want to encourage us that if you weren't here last Sunday, obviously via online, I really encourage us, go online to lifeau.org, capture the message, because for time, I can't go through it all and I don't want to try and recapture that. I just feel like we want to just really bring heart today. And then through that, we're going to have the opportunity together at the end to be able to, again, just clarify what God's saying for us all. And out of that, have the freedom to respond as we'd like. And then together, let's see the miracle unfold. Is that good? Awesome. Awesome. So, and the other highlight of capturing last week is you'll see some ugly tears and all of that messy, sniffly, snotty stuff. And I'm going to have to say to you, I can't promise it's not going to happen again today. We had our financial leaders here yesterday, and I got to say, I didn't expect it to happen in that environment. But it's just like, I'm like, something is in the air at the moment. I grab this microphone, and the eyes start watering at the moment. And so I'm just believing that, again, God will just do what he wants to do. You can't manufacture God. You can't manufacture a moment like this. And you might be in church saying, oh, so it's finances. You're talking about giving money. Absolutely. Absolutely. No, and that's not to rev anyone up, but absolutely. We sow into so many things in life that are temporal. And here we are having the opportunity to sow into something that is eternal. And I'm going to share hard on that. But I asked this question last Sunday, if you remember it. The question was, are we willing? Are we willing? And out of 1 Chronicles 28:2, he said, King David rose to his feet and he said, listen to me, my fellow Israelites, my people. I had it in my heart to build a house as a place of rest for the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, for the footstool of our God, and I made plans to build it. I love this. Here is David, and he has it in his heart to build God's house. I just love that. And what God put in my and stirred in my spirit last week, and as we talked about it, was, are we willing? In that sense of what's in our heart when it comes to the opportunity to build God's house, to establish what he's wanting to do here in Melbourne and beyond. What's in our heart? Is there something that's like stirring that we want to tell people? Here he is gathering all the people. Guys, guess what's in my heart? I'm willing to build God a house. I mean, I've got, and literally in 2 Samuel 7, he says, I've got my house, yet Jesus, God, his presence lives in a tent. What is he doing in the temporary and I'm in the permanent? No, his presence needs the permanent so I can then go, and if I need to live in the temporary, live in the temporary. But I've just loved that this week as we've fasted together, as we've prayed together, I've really felt a stirring in my heart, and I really have this great God confidence and an encouragement, as many have been talking over the week, as I feel like the statement has changed from not are we willing, but a resounding statement that we are willing. Come on, that we are willing. That we are willing. I've got something in my heart that I want to do. I've got something from my family that we want to partner with. And again, I'm not going to apologize, but I want to prepare you that, as if I'm not already, but I feel like I'm going to get a little passionate, because we are willing. My heart started to run, and I started to think about, why are we willing? Why are we willing? We're willing because we're building God's church, right? We're building his house. We're not building my house. I love what 1 Chronicles 29 says. David said to the whole assembly, hey guys, my son Solomon, who is the one that God has chosen, he's young and inexperienced. The task is great. The palatial structure, listen to it. It's not for man, but it is for the Lord. What I love about expansion is not about our vision. It's about God's vision. It's about what God's given us, and it's about us stepping into that. See, today I declare that we are willing. We are willing for expansion because we are willing to build God's house. We're willing to build his church. See, I believe today that when we are willing, we're willing to build a house that heals the brokenhearted. Yes. Come on, a house that's going to feed the hungry, that loves the lonely, and we're going to build a place that everybody belongs. Yes. We're building the church. Yes. We're building a home for those that are hurting, that those that need receive ministry, and those that need to know there was a life they never thought they could have or nobody told them about, but God has declared from the beginning is theirs to live. We're building marriages and families, and we're enabling the prodigals to come home, where the lost are found and the weak are made strong. We're building his church. Come on, we're building a home that will be a refuge for those robbed of hope. And not only will they recover, but they will be released with unshakable, come on, anchor of a sure foundation to reach our shaking society. We're building a house, a place of restoration, reconciliation, and redemption, a house of the miraculous, the divine, and a place of destiny. I'm sowing into his church. We're building a church where people will encounter the wonder of their Savior, a place where, where every culture is celebrated, because God's hand was the same hand that formed every life in the womb from the very beginning. A home where truth triumphs, where grace is giving in abundance and mercy makes a way. A home where unconditional love and uncompromising truth is declared week in, week out. A house where arms are wide open for all to belong. And that we can all journey in from the place to believe and discover a kingdom worth building. We're building his church. Why am I passionate? Why am I willing? Because this ain't for man. This is for the Lord. A place where the enemy's plans are thwarted, his schemes are defeated, and the doctor's diagnoses are defied. Where guilty consciences are made clean, where condemnation melts away, and the grace and love of Jesus reigns above all. A place where his presence will set every captive free. Chains will break, addictions fall away, and we will see the dead areas of people's lives rise to life. And in Jesus' name, I'm believing that the physically dead will be again declared alive. Today, we're building his church. We're building a church where the preaching of his life-giving word will be declared fearlessly, where the Holy Spirit consistently moves in power and the presence of God cannot be contained. We're building a church where insecurity and isolation will be infiltrated with the truth of God's love, life, and destiny, where identities will be restored, vision birthed, and dreams will be released. We're building his church. A home where family is formed and unity is found as every culture, every generation lifts up the name of Jesus. From generational bondage, there will be generational breakthrough. A home of faith, fun, joy, and endless laughter at the goodness of God. We're building His church. A church that's steadfast. A church that builds strong men. Vision-filled women. People who are courageous, humble, honorable, dedicated, devoted to God, and we're devoted to others. A house that raises and releases the fearless. Declares the life-giving, mercy-showing grace of our God. A church where the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord dwells. Where good news is preached to the poor, where broken hearts are bound up, captives are released, the year of the Lord's favor is declared. This is God's church. Where gladness anoints the mourners, beauty replaces the ashes, praise clothes the dispersed, and hearts dispersed. Don't know if we can edit that out live, but where hearts transform, encounter, and exchange everyday realities with the wonder of His grace. We're building His church. A place we're going to build where there's going to rise up a generation of builders, leaders, visionaries, pioneers, evangelists, teachers, prophets, and they're going to go to the nations and they're going to be equipped and released to fulfill their kingdom cause. We're building a place where no persecution, accusation, or intimidation can ever penetrate the very fact that this is God's kingdom. It's unshakable and it's unbreakable, and love her, despise her, or despise her, you will not be able to sidestep her. We're building His church filled with His glory, a cornerstone for our society, a hope of the world where every dry soul is satisfied with the purest of living waters, where Jesus' name will and will always be Lord of all. We're building a house of salvation. We're building a house for revival. We are building God's church. Can I say it clearly? We are willing. We are willing. And I believe that not by any work of any man's hand, but by God's grace and by just the sovereignty of who He is, He's entrusting us. As David said to Solomon, I believe God is saying to us, not because of the name of our church, but because it's the time and His timing, He's saying, these are my kids whom I've chosen. It's time to step into it. So I wanted to have a moment where we could capture again just the story somewhat from start to finish that we shared last Sunday, where again, it just puts us in perspective of what God has done to enable this chosen moment and for us to again capture the heart of where God wants to lead us. And then I'd love to just invite a friend to come and just share. And we're just going to again just go, you know what? We're not here to renovate a building. We're here to restore a city, and we're here to build people. Come on, let's go to the screens and check out the video. Having just received notice while we were in lockdown that the landlord wanted us to move, I'll always cherish the instant peace and confidence that he put in my heart, saying, this is not the landlord shutting the door, but this is me opening a new one. At the start of this year, while after months of absolutely no doors opening, we felt every Sunday God was saying, declare expansion. And as we were searching in the market for another property to lease, God miraculously led us to this land. I'll never forget that Thursday afternoon on January the 28th, going to view another property listing for what literally seemed beyond comprehension. And as I drove into this car park, the Holy Spirit leapt in my chest, saying, I'm in this. And from that moment to this, we have witnessed miracle after miracle unfold. In fact, the next morning on the Friday, the 29th of January, I actually walked into this very room and I saw us sharing the miracle of what God had done and the vision of what we dreamed would be. And I actually believe that this is that same moment. And while we've always carried God-sized dreams in our heart, I can honestly say, what we are standing in right now is truly exceedingly abundantly above what we could have ever asked, thought, or imagined. I mean, the location, citywide accessibility, the new Westgate Tunnel accessibility, positioned ready to serve the 7,000 plus residents just across the river, it's miraculous. the right highly gifted people within life with a skill set for a kingdom venture of this size? Miraculous. To 100% secure the full financial lending required in such a short time frame, it's miraculous. To have the abundant space for not just incredible church experiences, but future community engagement and training facilities that will enable us to have a vibrant community hub. It's miraculous. And to have the development potential that we will continually expand, the potential for future childcare, and even the added revenue streams that can come in from what's possible, it's miraculous. And to think that all of this in under 90 days, we went from the security of God's promise, yet nothing in the natural, to signing and going unconditional, securing this kingdom property, I believe it's truly supernatural. You know, the day before actually receiving any details onto what this is now, our future home, God gave me a picture of an aircraft carrier. And as I looked into it, I discovered the purpose of these vessels are to carry, equip, deploy, and recover. And I believe without question that this is our God-given vessel that He is entrusting us to carry, to serve, love, and care for more people with a whole new capacity, creating an authentic community where everyone can belong and discover a church to call home. That we're here to equip, that we would see every desiring heart disciple to discover the truth of who God destines them to be, enabling them the freedom and the transformation from the inside out through the teaching of God's word. That people are going to be deployed. You know, I see hundreds, if not thousands, activated into their God-given purpose with a united mission to see God's kingdom advance through every sphere of society and to recover, to be a refuge for the hurting, those crushed in faith, wondering if God could still use them. That through care and encounter, we will see the love and power of God restore hearts and release fresh vision and purpose. As we gather here that Heart and Soul Night for the first time to have worship and communion as a team, from that moment, I believe this property shifted from an industrial land to holy ground and from an empty warehouse to God's house. Commissioned for the miraculous, where countless lives will encounter and be transformed by the love of Jesus. See, we are not here to renovate a building. We are here to restore a city. We are so excited by our first step and the plans that we have to repurpose this vibrant industrial space. We're going to have great kids facilities, also areas for endless connection, activity midweek, and we're going to be constructing a purpose-built auditorium that will enable a capacity for the generations to come. Through our expansion offering, we're going to sow into the stage one fit out, and we're going to create a home where I know in the days to come, thousands from all generations, cultures, and backgrounds, they're going to gather together and we're going to become family. And with one voice, we're going to lift up the name of Jesus. We know that this isn't just simply about our church called Life, but we believe it's about the church. And I believe that this is actually a moment in history where decades from now, we are going to look back and we're going to marvel at the wonder of all God has done and is continuing to do. But not only that, I believe we will be humbled at the great honor that we get to play our part. See, what God has done over the last 7 years has been amazing. And we absolutely love the people who call Life home, for He is calling us into expansion. The expansion of His kingdom, His house, and His church here in our great city. So I'm declaring it now. This is God's house, and together it's going to be built by God's people. So for all of our Life Melbourne family and those who feel led by God to partner, today is our expansion offering. And my prayer is just as the Holy Spirit leapt in me the moment I drove on, He's going to leap in all of our hearts in the same way, and He's going to say, I'm in this. Say yes to the bigness of God. Take a step of faith. And through expansion offering and our generosity, we're going to see miracle after miracle unfold. The restoration of our city outworked and the name of Jesus raised high over Melbourne and beyond. Come on, how good is God? How big is God? He's a waymaker. He is a waymaker. For we are not here to renovate buildings. We are here to restore a city. I just had the thought, like, what were you like when you walked in? I know what I was like. I know how empty I was. I knew I tried everything to find something that would fulfill the void. Nothing. Nothing met me. I knew how superficial my friendships were. And I knew very clearly how much I didn't see my life beyond the age of 21. But then I walked into his church. I walked into his church and I found a family. I walked into his church and I didn't discover a religion, but I discovered a God who so loved that he gave his only son, Jesus, to die for me. And he set up his church. He came to earth and he set up his bride, his church, as a place of beauty and a place of inclusion and a place of grace and mercy so that Craig one day, 2,000 years later, would walk through those doors and not encounter a whole lot of rules, but encounter the greatest love exchange. That when my heart was ready, I got to run down the front of that altar and go, God, you can take all of me. In my board shorts, in my long hair, my no shoes. You can take all of me. What's awesome is my own son runs in here with a mullet, no shoes, and he's taken all of us. And he didn't just say, oh, I love you as you are, mate. Yes, he loved me as I was. But the fact I couldn't see my life beyond another 2 years is because he had a whole nother life to show me. And from there, I don't know how you walked in. And this might be the very first day you've ever walked into a church. What an absolute honor of ours to have you here. It might be the very first time you're tuning in because you've just felt like, what is this church about? What is this thing? Why do I keep thinking about a God? And why do I think about that? I might as well just Google something and jump online. And you've joined us today. I want to tell you, how you walk in is so important. But what God does in your heart, not just in the room, but what he wants to do in your heart, changes everything. And the incredible thing is that God chooses to use us. He used people to love me. He used people to become my family. He used people to show me what I couldn't see. He used people. He used people to lead me to the point of baptism. He used people, right, to create environments and places where I could discover my spiritual gifts and discover that, you know, there's things that God knit there from the very moment your life started. You don't have to go and earn it. It's already in there, but you do need to unlock it and receive. He used people to all of a sudden unlock this life I never knew. I don't know what it was like when you walked in, and I don't know how you stand here now or sit here now, but the truth of it is, are you grateful for his church? And if it's not just me, I believe and I thank God for the culture and the heart of our house is that, my gosh, God, if we could be a part of making this message go further. Come on, if you could just use me to help this extend out, that somebody else could be loved. And I got to tell you, that picture of the aircraft carrier at the start of this year was just like nothing I'd seen before. It was like God said, there's an aircraft carrier coming and you're going to carry more people than you've ever carried before. Come on, you're going to equip more people than ever before with my love, my hope, my truths, my calling, my gifts. Come on, you're going to deploy people. Look at people are going to discover the purpose of God on their life. They're going to be more set apart to go out than they've ever known before. And we're going to be a place of recovery. I want to tell you that that is something that's dear in my heart, this whole idea of recovery. Very quickly, when we landed in Melbourne seven and a half years ago, I got a huge heart, not only for people who don't know Jesus, but I actually got a huge heart for people who are Christians who love God but are displaced. They don't have a home. Or maybe they had a home and things have happened and there's hurt in their heart and they're struggling to trust again, struggling to go, I don't know if I can entrust myself into a place, but my heart loves God. And I love the reality of what the church can become, but I just, from what I've experienced, I'm sheltered, I'm shielded. I don't know if I want to go there. And I felt like God, honestly, he's graced us. By his grace, he's graced us to be a place where people who love God but are disconnected, are displaced, they're going to recover. They're going to recover their love for God's house. They're going to recover their ability to trust. They're going to recover the fact that God has called them to build his church, be a part of his bride, and make it beautiful. And through what they've learned and what God wants to do, he's going to unlock all that dirt and he's going to release and enable something to be a flourishing in the seasons of their life. And I love that. And he said, this is what I, and I just believe God's just saying, it's time. It's time on a whole nother level. It's time. And I just have just, Nadia and I, honestly, we say this all the time. We believe that it's by no chance the people walk through the door who walk through the door. Even if it's just for one day. It's by no chance. And the people who have said, you know what, I feel like this is home. Don't you love that? That it's God's house, but it's home. They walk in, they feel, I feel like it's home. And then they meet somebody. And then they hang out. And then they connect. And then God's presence meets them in worship. And then God's word just does something like a seed in their heart that starts to speak and shape. And just the way it just does phenomenal things. And then not only do they just go, oh, well, I'm going and I'm attending. But actually, no, they're family. And in that, they love and they care. And just the body, the family of God just grows. And that's what we're a part of. Expansion is that. It's about extending God's house, extending that love and extending that care. And I thought it would be cool today to have a friend of mine, Alana, come up and just share. Her and Colin are an awesome part of our church and have been for a number of years. But I thought it would be cool for Alana to come and just share. Share her journey and share her experience and what her heart is around this. And it's over to you, Lance. I'd love you to go for it, mate.
Good morning. He's talking about me. I'm super pumped to be here just to celebrate basically how good God is. It's like my favorite topic in the world is to tell people how kind he is and how good he is. So good. And this is our story. Like we're Christians for many years. We lived in Brisbane and we weren't necessarily displaced or hadn't walked away from church. We just moved cities. But we definitely were in a season of burnout and I'm not going to go into the details for why. I needed some renewal in our mind. But we came here just exhausted, basically. And God had spoken very clearly to me when we moved cities. He said, this will be a period of rest. I was so happy to hear that. I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. I need this rest, like godly rest. And through a process, a whole adventure, we landed at Life. And within about 2 weeks, felt more welcome here than we, or more at home, like as in this is where God wants us planted, than we had in a year of sort of shopping around churches of Melbourne. Like we just hadn't found that home that God wanted for us. But the moment we walked through the door, we had that clear sense of this is it. And I think the beautiful thing about that first moment here at Life was that we were just welcomed as we were. It wasn't about what we could do or the capacity on our lives or what we could offer the church. It was just us as people. We were just welcomed into the family, which was so healing at the time and continues to be so. But where am I going with this? Yes, it was beautiful healing time. We were allowed to just rest. Craig and Nards were super gracious. They're like, you just chill, like you just come, just be part of the family. We got you, just relax. And that was beautiful. And after a period of time of healing and rest that God had promised us, you know, we jumped back on team and got back involved. And we've been involved in many places over the 5 years, I think we've been here now, which has been awesome. But to like, just talk about what Craig is talking about, the house that God has created here and the family that he's created here. I just want to celebrate how real and how God breathed and anointed this family is. I've never engaged so deeply with church community before. And God has taken Colin and I on a big adventure in that space. But the people here and the way that we all walk with God is just so beautiful. We've been on a massive adventure with our fertility journey, which was a difficult one, but we can see a bit of progress here.
Hey, hey. Come on.
Miracle worker, waymaker. Yeah, it's right here. We'll talk about that another time. But that was a difficult journey. It was a long one. It was very long. And we learned a lot in our relationship with God. But to be honest, it's not because I'm some hero of the faith and Colin's some hero of the faith. You know, like we're just regular people. But we were carried by this community. We were carried through that season and learning to know God better. And like everything that comes with that has been such a mind blow. But yeah, the community here is so healthy. And I'm super excited about this next season. Yeah. When Craig first shared it, I was a bit like, whoa, that's huge. Like, what? Really? I didn't expect that. And I don't think anybody expected that, really. Yeah, it's like left field for all of us. But I think the beautiful thing, when I was praying through it, God showed me that, like, this beautiful family home here at Life Melbourne is like our little first family home, you know, like the little home you first move into when you're a young married couple and you like buy your first little house. And it's been such a treasured family home. But then God sort of zoomed the picture out for me and showed me people, like lots of people, that he can see in the future. Like it wasn't a territory zoom out, it was like a time zoom out. And he could see those people in the future. And he knew that we needed more bedrooms. We knew we need a bigger family home. We didn't know that, but he does. And he knows those people coming. So I'm excited for the community that I've encountered here personally and the impact that that's had on me, not just a community of people, but it's God's family. And I've learned to know God like at a crazy deeper level through this community. And I can't wait for more people to discover the same, which is exactly what Craig's been saying. So testify to that.
Come on, you're amazing, Lance. Thank you. Come on, why don't we thank Alana for just sharing heart and being vulnerable and amazing. Isn't it amazing what God does? So awesome. And you know, the reality is today that we are taking an opportunity to do a one-off offering and commit over the next 12 months about how we are going to step into expansion. Step into the reality of occupying our new home and enabling more rooms to be added so we can make room for more people to be cared for and loved. And I just wanted to encourage us. I thought it would be good for us to be able to walk through just the vision and the goal that we have in front of us. And so whether you're joining us at home, online, you're definitely much a part of this as everybody in the room. But what we have before us is a goal that over the next 2.5 years, through all of us just responding as God puts in our heart to respond and doing with what's in our heart to do, that over the next 2 years, we'll be able to raise $2.75 million to enable the fit out and also the framing up of the future. All right, so that's what we're stepping into in the next right now, really. And so in the reality of fitting out and framing up the future, what we're going to be doing, as you saw in that video, is we've kind of got the highlighted blue area. This is the whole area we occupy, or we own, sorry, this whole area, the whole yard, in that sense, the whole title. But we're occupying this immediately at the start. And what we're going to do is we're going to do the foyer and the kids area, but frame up means what we're doing is we're building immediately the future auditorium space for what God wants to step us into in the future. But we can't come back to redoing the roof. We want to do that now and get that structure up. And I just feel like God's saying, don't make it too small. Come on, don't make it too small. I love that. It's not a territory thing. It's a time thing of just going, I can already see what God wants to do. And so he's put us in that in our heart to take a step of faith to make the auditorium bigger, so that in the future it won't just be 500s, but it'll actually be up to about 900 plus seats. And so we've actually got a future. This is the foyer we saw in the video there. So it's going to be a really cool, fun, industrial space where a lot of that video footage was done. That's what's going to transform this area. Going to be awesome kids facilities as well. Looking forward to that. We love our generations. We love our kids. So that's going to be amazing. And then also inside that new auditorium structure is this stage and this whole auditorium that we're going to be part of. And there is a very beautiful woman on the screen, which is awesome. Everyone's too nervous. Should we whistle or should we not? Yeah, get on with it. She's divine. And then so the future, what that enables us to do is if we build that auditorium structure, which is here, that means that in the future, the areas that have other tenants in, but yet we still own it, what we're going to be able to do is be able to then start to occupy all this other space and have, just a really great engagement area, community area, dining, all the kids' facilities, maybe even a chapel area for weddings and for acoustic services and youth facilities, and the generations are going to be cared for. But not only that, this area here is actually a three-story building at which we're believing we're going to be able to do education, we're going to have room for training, we're going to have a whole lot of community, because we want a community hub, right? We're in a place. And then a part of that development and increasing this area here, we're going to need to build a car parking building. And the incredible thing that within that is we can actually put the possibility, and this is all what I call napkin dreaming, but we can put offices on top, even a childcare can become a part of it. And it's not napkin dreaming as in like it's just wishful thinking. These are all actually things that are within the industrial zone permit. These things can happen. So this is all part of actually like strategic planning. But if you can see it, one back, guys. If you can see it, you can see the reality that it becomes a vibrant place of activity that is literally on the corner of Melbourne City Council. The corner as you come in from Footscray going in is just going to be phenomenal. Just absolutely amazing. And then also within that, we're believing there's going to be increased revenue streams that are going to enable the funding of what God wants to do in our community arm and to see us just continually extend to meet the needs of people. Is that exciting? Part of this expansion offering as well, the 2.75 over the next 2 years, is going towards our community and kingdom. It's a huge part of who we are. It's not just about what we're doing building-wise, it's also about what we're doing reach-wise. And so our Christmas boxes this year, we did 9,000 last year. We're believing to do 11,500 this year, which is going to be awesome across three states, which is great. Life TV is expanding around Australia and around the world. Our conferences, which are part of Kingdom, every conference we have is Life. You are a part of it. You are seeding into it. Every fruit that comes from it, you are invested in that. And I love that. As a family, Nadia and I, we love that. We've got Community Kitchen that's taking place. We want to expand that out to the West. Festival, we want that running in the Footscray area when we get landed there. CAP, Sports Chaplaincy, Red Frogs. Like, we just want to keep expanding the area of community and care and help. And then also Embrace Grace, which is a new initiative that we're getting behind, which is all about supporting women and families in unplanned pregnancies and enabling that support there. Why? Because every life matters and we want to be a part of enabling that to take place. So brilliant. Thanks, guys. So that's the goal over the next 2.5 years. So the reality in that as well, though, is that for this to happen, I felt like God just said, keep it simple. So over the next 2 years, let's just break it down into 1 year and then another year, right? 12 months and then another 12 months. And so what we're believing over the next 12 months is that we could raise 1.25 million by, again, through a step of faith for all of us, all doing what God's put in our heart. We've all got different capacity, but we want to have the same level of obedience, right? That we just step together. And then next year, as we grow and expand, we can go to 1.5, which gets us to that 2.75. And so again, just clarifying, that means today we want to do a one-off offering. And then for, I believe for majority of us, there's going to be something in our spirit that says over the next 12 months, I can believe that we can do this, which is fantastic. And so it's pretty exciting. In this whole journey, we've been sticking and walking out alongside, sorry, team, band, you can come and join me because we're going to have a moment where we can just have that time to fresh get God's clarity. I know there's a lot of information that you're hearing right now, but I pray that you're capturing the heart behind it. But the reality is we've been planted out of the scripture in 1 Chronicles 28 and 29, and it's all around David, God's son, having a heart to build God's house. And he speaks about it to the people, as I said before, wow, God's chosen my son Solomon, and we're building this house that's for God. And then from that place, he starts to give offerings out of what was available to him in the city treasury. But then from that, he started giving from his own heart. He actually says it in chapter 29. He says, out of my devotion, out of my heart for God's house, I'm going to give this. And he gives and he records what he gives. And it's astronomical, right? But from there, he actually then goes and actually publicly tells everybody in this community, everybody, all the Israelites, he gets the people together and goes, guys, look what myself and the leaders have done. Look what they've done. They've gone before you. And because they believe in also building God's house. And I just felt when I read that the other week, I felt like God say, why don't you invite your core leaders, your staff, your board, and those who are our age group pastors, why don't you invite them to pre-commit? If it be in their heart to pre-commit, we could pre-commit and we could have that moment where we say, you know what, guys, we're not asking you to do something that's not in our heart, but this is in our heart and we want to go. And today we're on that number that we've already pre-committed. It's floating because I just want the clarity of heaven on that. And so anyway, on Wednesday morning, we got together and we prayed together in our little office and we just had some time worshiping. And then we just said, as families and individuals, this is what we're going to do. And so what we've been able to do within, I guess, this next 12 months, again, so we're just looking at the 12 months ahead of us. The next 12 months, we're believing for 166 giving units and that we would see 1.25. And I believe that we could exceed that in Jesus' name. But we were able to, on Wednesday, the team, we qualified, I guess, or gathered 17 giving units within that team. And through that, again, out of prayer and just hearing from God and just responding in faith, and I love that. These are faith moments for all of us. God wants to grow us and expand us. But in faith, we were able to pre-commit and receive $365,500 towards this year's 12-month goal, which I think is pretty incredible. It's worth celebrating. How encouraging is that? And what I love is that it says the people rejoiced and David rejoiced. Come on, as your pastor, when I saw that, like something leapt in me and just going, God, wow. And you know, you love it that actually David goes from that. He goes, God, wow. How amazing is your name? How incredible are you? And I just pray that today that would be the response of all of our heart. That is, we all get to give on the other side of us doing what God's asked to do. We're all like, wow, God, how awesome are you? How amazing is it that we can partner with your kingdom for your time as such a time as this? Because I believe that it's God's people that are called to build God's church. And that we are God's people. And we are God's church. And we're here to build his church. Are you ready to build God's church? And maybe you haven't had a moment to be able to hear from God and get clarity on it. I would just say God can speak. And then just take a step and respond. And I know many of us have come today ready to go because it's a day of celebration. But I would love to take a moment to pray. And then we're going to have a really encouraging moment. The team are going to lead us. And it's something that ties in between this venue here and the promise of what we're stepping into. And the truth of it is that we together will build the church. So Father, we do thank you for this holy moment. We thank you for what you're leading right here, right now. And God, I pray, Lord, that you would speak clearly, that you would lead freely, and Lord, that there would be a willingness in our heart. We thank you, Lord, that the church, for what it has done in our lives. God, we stand here, Lord, not thinking we earned it or deserved it, but we're grateful for the way that you've moved in our hearts and in our lives and in our families. But Father, we take up the mantle and we say, it's our chance. This is our time. We were born for such a time as this. We're here to build your house. We're here to stand your church. We're here to step into expansion. So Father, I pray for this just to be a holy moment, a moment again where you just confirm what you're doing and you release your purpose. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen and amen. Come on, let's have this moment together.
Chief cornerstone, no other foundation can we build upon. Not philosophy, nor the wisdom of man, nor the ground is sinking sand. Upon this rock, you build your church, and the gates of hell will not prevail. When we bind and loose, we proclaim your truth, and in Jesus' name we will not fail.
Upon this rock, you build.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Don't you love that? Come on, from our new home to our current, we're declaring together, we are the church building the church. I want to take a couple of moments just to be able to help us to know, okay, well, from here, how do we do that? Because we're going to take the one-off offering and make that pledge now in this moment. And it's so exciting. And so what we've done is we've prepared a few forms to be able to enable us all to do that in this moment. So I'm actually going to encourage everyone in the seat pocket in front of you, you'll see this here expansion card. Just grab that, stay standing, but grab hold of that. If you're at home with us, obviously you'll see it next to me. There's the form that we're all looking at. But basically what I'd love us all to do is to be able to just put a, and you'll see a pen there as well, but you'll be able to put your details in. Again, we're going to let you know in just a moment how we can do it electronically, if you'd want to do that through your phone and through an app. But just capture this for a moment. But you can put your name and details on the front there. And then obviously, today we've got a one-off offering, and then also what we're believing over the next 12 months, which comes to a total. All right, and so we'd love you just to take a moment and go, well, okay, today if we just talked about it practically, I want to do it in 12 months, I want to do 1,000, or maybe as a family, we can believe with what God's doing through us and what how He's blessed us that today we could do 20,000. Or maybe you're here and you're someone who's actually a multi-millionaire. That's just the reality of how God has blessed you and He's led you in your world. The truth of it is you might go, well, 2.75, that's actually not a lot when I look at what I'm a part of and what I do. I want to encourage you that we've got a vision that goes way beyond the next 2 years. And I would love this to be a moment of faith for you. And so if you say, Craig, well, if there's actually more vision to sow into, I'd love it to be a moment of stirring in my spirit. So even this moment might be God going, hey, have a conversation, find out more, because I'm telling you what God wants to unlock, wants your faith attached to it. And so we could all just be in that place where we go, God, what is you asking of me? And so, but feel free again, as I said, if you are a millionaire, you could put four, just a little four in front of those six zeros in that total is fantastic. But no, like put in what's in your heart, what you're going to do. Then as well on the back, it gives you the opportunity to be able to go, well, actually, we'd love to fulfill that, obviously, that one-off offering today. And it lets you know the different ways you can do that, all right? So if you want to do it by credit card, you do that, you make payments like that, you can do that. And then the second box lets you know about how you could set something up over the next 12 months. So Nadia and I, what we love to do is we'll make a level of commitment today towards our total, but then also over the next, every week, we'll contribute and commit to that. And so we set up an automatic payment in regards to or a bank transfer every week. So that's part of what we're committing to. And it helps us go towards seeing in 12 months, us be able to go, God, look what you've done through us, which is great. But if you're here and you say, well, Craig, I keep cash under the mattress and I still operate like that, then we've got an envelope as well in the seat pocket in front of you. You can use that today. And so you can put that inside the envelope and again, be a part of that moment. And then in a few minutes' time, containers, as we worship, containers will come past. And you can put that completed card or the envelope, put that into the container as it comes past, which would be great. Or if, as well, you're like us, you want to do it on electronic by your device, then scan the QR code there. If you've been at home watching this, you'll have seen the QR code next to me while I've been talking. You can scan that, and that's only going to take you, that's actually going to take you to our expansion website. And this is a really easy way of doing it. And basically, all you need to do is hit the give button that you're going to see there, jump into that, then it's going to take you to, you push the start button as the next screen, and then you're going to come onto the giving platform where you can just put your details in, your name, your email, very simple. When you go to the next slide, it's actually going to ask you what your total is, your one-off offering is, and then also your 12-month, and it's actually going to auto-populate the bottom number. And so if you're like, oh, well, great, I'm not that great with maths, then go the app, it'll work it out for you. And what's great from there is once it's right and you're happy with it, then just push the submit button, and then that's going to take you to pretty much what is like this, but through our PushPay app. And that means you can then just click, I want to fulfill my one-off now, and that's going to take you to the PushPay app, which you can do that, which you probably already have set up. So we want to make it as easy as possible, all right? Multiple ways to do that, which is good. But I really hope there's been some clarity around that. But I believe today, hey, we're given by faith. I know that we need some practical instruction because we don't want to miss this moment, but I'm really believing that 166 units, I'm believing that's going to be well exceeded. Because every individual couple and family says, you know what, life's my home and I know I'm called to be a part of the vision. We're in, you can count us in. So I pray that this is a moment that for you, you feel like it's a faith God moment. Something that's skipping in your heart saying, God, I may be big right now for the season, but I do feel it's you. And so I want to be obedient to what you're leading in my heart. And I believe God doesn't want to just expand our church. Hear this clearly. He wants to expand your heart. He wants to expand your life. He wants to expand what He wants to entrust into you. Father, we thank You for every person as they take the step of faith, as they fulfill what You've put in their heart. Father, I thank You, Lord God, that it's not just dollars and cents. I declare, Lord, it's supernatural seed. For every person at home who right now is filling that out online, doing it through the app, God, I thank You that this is a supernatural moment. And I declare expansion over every life, over every home, over every heart. An expansion of Your grace, an expansion of Your promise, an expansion of the dream that You've placed within them. And I pray, God, that for all of us, we'd have an expanded heart for You. That this moment would lead us just to love You more, to just be more in wonder of the goodness of God and what You've called us to be a part of. We honor You, we lift You up, and we declare You holy in Jesus' name. Everybody said, amen, amen.